Er zijn er al vijf, zegt hij. You're live.
Hoe lang plan je?
Het zal toch wel uitgeluld zijn. Ik heb er van 2 uur, ik heb er van 1,5 uur, ik heb er van 50 minuten. Als wij het leuk vinden, dan gaan we door. Ik ben net als jij, Jeroen. Het gaat bij mij voor de voet weg. Geen schema, geen ideeën.
Ik doe het ook niet. En als ik na 1,5 uur zat ben, ben ik na 1,5 uur zat.
Ja, dat is het ook goed. Dan moeten we alleen even kijken hoe we dat willen doen. Als jij je slides klaar hebt staan, dan kan ik naar jouw computer voor de slides. Dan gaan we eerst de inleiding doen waarin jij jouw verhaal kan doen van je plannetjes, je coreplan en weet ik voor wat.
Ja, ik denk dat het een goede is voor mensen om uit te leggen wat zit er nu eigenlijk allemaal bij en hoe werkt dat.
Dan stel ik jou die vraag van, oké, Jeroen, hoe zit dat nou met al die licenties en wat kost nou wel geld en wat kost nou niet geld en wat heb je nou wel voor geld en wat heb je nou niet voor geld?
Ja.
Want de audio staat.
Eventjes kijken, we zijn hier nu.
Check.
Is een beetje irritant dat je. Ik hoef er geen eens bij. Kijk jij maar hoe lang je het.
It's 7 o'clock in the Netherlands from the And the Groove Remains Production Team Studios. My name is Mix Master G and this time we have a special guest, folks. We've got Jeroen Groenendijk and he is product manager with Pioneer DJ Europe. Jeroen, introduce yourself, please. What is your background as a DJ before you joined Pioneer, just to have a little bit of your credentials?
All right, well, hi guys, and if you want to have a challenge, then try to pronounce my first and my last name in any type you want, because it's a tongue twister, whatever you want. A little bit of an introduction of myself. My name is Jeroen Groenendijk. That's the proper way to pronounce it. I've been a DJ since 92. That's back then I bought my first turntables with belt-driven stuff. You probably have never seen such a turntable, but they really existed. In the 90s, I've been DJing on a lot of hardcore parties. That was it in the Netherlands. I had residence in Locomotion, in Sweet Lake City, as we call the place. And at the end of the 90s, in the beginning of the 90s, I started, 95, I started working at a professional audio company, selling professional audio. At the end of the 90s, 99 was the year that I started working at Pioneer. Back then it was still Pioneer. 2015 it became Pioneer DJ, but I'm still working there. So that's 21 years of experience within Pioneer. As a DJ, I've come across a lot of different places in clubs, in festivals, in events. So I've had my fair share of DJing. In those times of the beginning, you only had vinyl. So it was only about beat matching. That was the only thing that's important. And if you look at how the DJ has evolved over time, now it's much more a performer. And there's so much stuff happening in a DJ booth and also in the preparation. That's a real difference compared to back in the days. And yeah, I'm just moving along with the time.
And he has the same problem as I have. Give him one word and he feels like 3 hours. So sometimes I'm not rude to Jeroen. Jeroen and I know each other for quite some time. The first thing I did was ever walk into a presentation he was doing and totally ruined it by being too rude and interrupting all over the place. But after that, we came across each other. We know each other. We understand each other.
I still remember that. That was the dance fair. And that was during a session of the guy that wanted to do a demonstration of RMX 1000.
Yep.
And you keep interrupting him.
Yep, that's correct.
And then we were like, who's this guy? I got to talk to him.
And that was me. So, but in the end, everything came fine. So we go back a long way, and I kind of call him my friend, and I don't call many people a friend. At least he got exactly the same DJ heart I have and the same background. Well, as you can understand, with somebody from Recordbox or from Pioneer available, Recordbox 6 is, of course, on the menu. And the most important thing that is striking everybody with Recordbox is what is going on with the subscription plan. Do I have to buy it? Do I need a subscription plan? What is included? What is not included? And there is a lot of bad information about it. So let's hear that from the horse's mouth and just ask Jeroen if he can tell us DJs in plain terms, what are the plans and why should we need one? I'm going to switch screens to Jeroen's laptop. There we are. And we even got Jeroen's laptop with a...
With my face.
With yours.
Yeah, perfect.
Because we are still live, this is actually happening, folks. All right, I'm going to mute my cam and Jeroen will take this away because I don't know how the audio is if we are both together on it.
We try to talk in terms and not overrule each other. Okay, let me tell you a little bit about the plans and all the opportunities. The first thing I want to say is that I think that the majority of people do not need any of the paid subscription plans. Yes, paid subscription plans is the thing that we've introduced. Who will be able to use the free plan? I think the majority of people. If you are using Recordbox to export your files to a USB or SD device, then you have enough on the free plan. If you want to just play around with Recordbox, now with Recordbox 6, the free plan also includes the Recordbox Performance Mode or Recordbox DJ, depending on how you want to call it. So on your computer, you can use Recordbox DJ at any time with the free plan. If you want to control Recordbox DJ with a controller, the free plan covers all the most modern controllers that we have. Recordbox dedicated controllers. There is a group of controllers that is not initially made for Recordbox, so like a Serato controller. Those are not covered by the basic plan or by the free plan, as it is called. What you also get with the free plan is Wi-Fi sync. So you can use Recordbox in conjunction with your phone and you can export or transfer files to your phone. And these can be synchronized. That's via Wi-Fi, so you have to have a Wi-Fi connection between your computer and your phone. But you can use your phone as a full-fledged on device. You can create your playlist, you can change playlist, you can create beat grids, you can do everything on your phone at any point in time or wherever you want. Just do it in leisure time. Then you can synchronize all this information back to your computer, so you can actually really work on your collection on your phone if you would want to do it. So the free plan, if you're just exporting tracks and if you are using any of the modern controllers, it's all covered by the free plan. If you take the next step is what we call the core subscription plan. The core subscription plan you need if you have a controller that is not, I think we are on the screen, yeah. If you have the list, if you have a controller that's not on this list, then you need to have the core plan to be able to use your controller with the Rekordbox DJ software. The core plan is one step up, so that's the mid-tier. And actually, the people that need the core plan are the people that have a controller that was not in the previous list or not a dedicated Pioneer controller. So if you would be using a Native Instruments or a Newmark or whatever brand controller you have, if you want to use that with Rekordbox DJ, in order for that to work, you need to have the core subscription plan. But then keep in mind that the controller is purchased for a different type of software. So you're going to use it outside of the reach for which you originally bought that controller. With the core plan, you also have the opportunity to synchronize over Wi-Fi two computers with each other. So you can have like two MacBooks or a MacBook. Well, you have two MacBooks and you can use them together to work on your collection. If you take it up to the maximum level, that's what we call the creative subscription plan. And with creative, you actually get everything. All the plus packs, as it was called, are going to work. You get all the features. And I think that the biggest and most important thing, at least for me from Pioneer side, is the cloud sync over all your devices. The cloud sync means that you will be able to synchronize all your devices together. So you can have a MacBook, you can have a Windows PC, you can have an iPad, you can have a phone, you can have an Android phone, not five, but four of them, and you can hook everything together. So they talk to each other and they can work on the same collection. So that makes it easy if you're on a travel that you have your stationary computer at home, you have your laptop for on the road, every change that you're going to do can be synchronized with the cloud. So you have all your computers up to date. There's well one thing that you need for that, because the cloud sync is only synchronizing the database of your collection with all those systems. You need a way to share also your files. Pioneer has decided that Dropbox at this point in time is the chosen format, so you also need to have a Dropbox account to synchronize all your music. And that's a little bit the pitfall. If you have a license for Rekordbox 5, unfortunately, it's not possible to use that license on Rekordbox 6. So if you have one of the old plus packs and if you would like to use it and you choose not to take one of the subscription plans, then you can only stick to Rekordbox 5 at this point in time. I think
that answers those questions. I've got some questions coming on Jeroen, and let me ask them to you. I think these will be a little bit hard for you to answer, but this is an Ask Me Anything, so people ask us anything.
Let's do it.
The first question is, why? Why did Pioneer DJ go from the model they had where you could buy plugins or extra packs, plus packs if you want, and just build your own Rekordbox? Why did they go to an entirely new model? Because the cloud feature is nice, but the big thing inside is, of course, the sharing with multiple devices of your database. And that is basically still free. Or am I wrong with that?
How do you mean? There's two questions in one. Why did Pioneer choose to go this route? Yep. Obviously, there's not a solid explanation for it. We are developing Rekordbox with a team of somewhere, I cannot call numbers, but there's a big group of engineers back in Japan, and they are working on constant level to Rekordbox. And at some point in time, if you look at how the whole world is evolving, it's unfortunately subscription is like the licensing system of the future. I'm having Dropbox, I need to pay monthly, I'm paying for Adobe, I'm paying for a lot of other things also. Is it something I would like? I would also prefer to have just a one-off fee. But this is what they have chosen, so this is how it's going to be. If you want to have the opportunity to buy Record Box like Six, if you want to buy it, we cannot. We don't have a licensing system to buy it. But if you would be buying a DDJ XP1 or an XP2, or that is a unit that unlocks the majority of all the plus packs. So if you want to have a one-off fee, I think DDJ XP2, which is an external pad with buttons, that unlocks the majority of all the features. So if you want to have a one-off fee, I think that's at this point in time your best bet.
I think that answers that. Then another
By the way, I see on the screen, if I look to you, Peter, I'm on the screen, I'm watching the other direction.
Yeah,
so please, for the viewers.
I watch to you and you watch the opposite. Yeah, now he's always looking away. That is who he is.
I'm now looking at Peter, so don't get me wrong. I'm not watching the other direction.
They are actually mirrored somehow, but the letters on the Nexus 2 is correct. So that, I don't know what's going on there. It must be technique.
Yeah.
All right.
We don't understand that, right?
we don't understand shit about technique. I wish I did. I can paint. I have a question from Joop Wessels. He just bought the video license of Record Box 5. And he didn't know that all this was planned. So I'm just shooting this at you, Jeroen. Can he get a refund somehow? Can he contact something inside Pioneer?
The thing is, if you have a video license, you probably also have a controller that controls your video things. And that controller unlocks also the features in Record Box 6. So if you have video, I would assume people are using something like a RZX controller, which unlocks the video and all the other plans. To prevent people are not so happy, what Pioneer tried to do is that last 3 months before we introduced Record Box 6, it was not longer available to purchase a license. So if licenses are purchased, it's more than 3 months away, 3 months ago. And to be honest, it's really hard if you introduce a new system that you make everybody happy.
There's always this gray area of...
I think Pioneer tried to close down our eShop to people to purchase a license for 3 months before we introduced Record Box 6. So that was the best effort Pioneer could do. That's a quarter of a year, and I don't think it's... I don't think a company can protect people for longer than that.
I think it's a fair point. I think it's fair, but you always have this problem. There is always this gray period where you either just bought it or didn't buy it, and that's with everything. There is always this twilight zone in between version changes. But it was kind of communicated, and if it is like Jeroen says, and I have no reason not to believe him, then it was not available anymore. So they already did everything they could to protect your last 3 months from making a mistake or a rookie purchase.
And one of the things is also that, and if you compare it to something different, I'm a paying customer for Adobe. Adobe, if you're watching, I'm open for a free license. But if you buy the old systems when Adobe was not a cloud system anymore, then you had the Creative Suite. If you buy the Creative Suite 2 and they release Creative Suite 3, a purchase of Creative Suite 2 was 2,800 or 2,900 euros. And if I wanted to upgrade to CS3, I needed to pay another 1,500 euros. Was that fair? It's just the licensing system that company has chosen. If I want to use Adobe for longer, it's my choice. And unfortunately, you will never have a license lifetime upgrades in all the majors. I wish it was that way, but that's unfortunately not how it works.
All right. I got another question from Michael. Michael is asking, why do I have Record Box let my collection analyze 2 times before I actually can use it? I must admit, I don't understand fully that question, because as far as I'm aware, if I'm migrating from Record Box 5 to 6, I don't have to analyze at all. The analyzation is all done.
I think I know what he means, Peter.
All right, Jeroen, take it away.
If you are going to upgrade from Record Box 5...
You want screen?
In a bit, because I think, no, if you, let's do me talk the talking
go
first.
Go ahead.
The first step, if you're going to upgrade from Rekordbox 4 to Rekordbox 5, because Rekordbox 4 to 5, okay, we go back a few years, from 5 to 6, and obviously Peter knows that, there's a different database structure in between the two systems, and they're not interchangeable. So before your Rekordbox 5 works, collection is going to work for Rekordbox 6, the database structure, I think that's the best to call it, needs to be changed. And if you upgrade, that's the first step that's going to happen. If you start up Rekordbox 6 for the first time, it will import your old collection. If you have a huge collection, I've spoken to people that are having like 100k tracks, that can take a long time. Sometimes it can be easier or better to cancel the initial import or the initial conversion step and do the conversion step from within Rekordbox 6. You switch the screens right away? Because I want to show the... Okay, Dave? Yeah. Come on, give me the output. If you are in Rekordbox 6 and you do not have all your tracks in, you can always go to File, you can go to Library, and here you will see as a new bottom option, import your collection from V5. And I didn't have any issues. I only have like 7,000 tracks in my collection. It took me about an hour, 15 minutes to do the conversion step. But I hear some people have better experience when they use the import from library function. This is the first step, and this is only a database conversion step. There will not be any analyzing during this process, even though it takes a bit of time. It does not analyze your tracks, it does not add any of the tracks, and it doesn't do anything other than converting the database to the new format. In my collection, all the tracks are there. Perhaps you can show your screen for a second, because this is how your collection will look like if you did the initial conversion of the whole thing. You will see your tracks, and I don't actually need to do, because the only thing that I want to show people is in this first column, I don't know, whatever. I'm gonna stick to my own camera. But if you look, and indeed, that's where you're aiming at, in that first column you see a question mark.
Yep.
So all your tracks will have this question mark. What does the question mark mean? That means that this track has not have all the information. One of the new features in Rekordbox 6 is that there's a new tricolor waveform. So you have to add this data. So if you right-click on one of those tracks, Peter, in the middle somewhere there's an option called Add New Analysis Data. If you click that button, yes. So if you hit that button, this track is getting the missing data added. And I see something else I want to add as well, Peter, that red bar at the bottom. I want to explain something about it. So what you do this way, by just add missing data, the only thing that you're going to add is a new waveform. There's no beat grid analyzing, there's no cue point shifting, it's purely adding the new information for the waveform. What I would suggest to do, if you have the time, is just right-click and choose Analyze File. But what's going to happen? If you analyze the file, the track is just going to be analyzed just as if it was imported into your collection. So then your beat grid might shift due to the new analyze engine that is in Rekordbox 6. I always, when there's a major, whenever we go to from 4 to 5, from 5 to 6, or any subversion, I sometimes know more than a little bit different people. But if there's a major, you can count on the fact that also our analyze engine is adapted or changed or upgraded. So I would suggest, if you have the time and you do not have 100,000 tracks in your collection, just analyze your files again, and probably a lot of stuff is getting analyzed better. There's one catch. Sometimes you have tracks that are really hard to beat grid, and then you spend a lot of time in them for beat gridding. In that case, I would suggest in the grid bar, there's a little padlock icon. If you lock that track even if you're analyzing all your files, the ones with the padlock activated will not get reanalyzed. So if you spend a lot of time and efforts and having like a dynamic beat grid, lock that track after you're done, and then it will never change, and you can freely just select all your tracks and add the analyzed data.
All right, then now about that red bar, the lyric search, because I've searched high and low in the preferences to find where can I disable that red bar with the lyrics search, because...
Yes, and I must freestyle a little bit, because... on my computer?
Yeah. Do it slow. My mouse is very quick, so move back to the screen. Yep, there. Now you can do whatever you want.
So first thing you will do is, that's the camera, that's the new camera. So you will go to the performance mode. As you see, Peter doesn't have a subscription plan, so everybody has the...
He's got a Nexus 2 kit. I will talk about that later. There's a Nexus 2 kit right in front of him, folks.
Yep, so why would you use Rekordbox DJ? But what you do is, here on the, you don't have Zoom it, on the top you have all the icons. And this icon with the ABC, that's the icon for the lyrics panel. If you click it, you don't have to click it, sorry. You go to the preferences, and now you will have a tab for the lyrics settings as well. If you click that button and you uncheck this box at the top, and this is also a suggested thing that I would do if you're not using lyrics, I think the majority of you guys are not using lyrics, turn this one off, because now it doesn't need to pull back to our server. If you do the... Okay, I really got to get used to your...
Fast mouse, huh?
Yeah. It's running like hell.
I know.
Okay, so this screen is your new analyze thing. What I would suggest is tick on BPM, tick on key. If you're using the lighting mode...
No, I don't want key and I don't want BPM. I use my own.
Yeah, but
stay
you
away.
Need to, you need to have the grid.
Yeah, but it are converted tracks, my friend.
Then next time I'm going to use my computer, because then I can show
Because the folks understand what you mean.
If you don't have a checkbox set, it's not going to analyze.
Yeah, it still will. It still will. Hold on. If we go to that famous, what you just explained to us, the export mode.
Oh, stay in my camera.
And I don't need the preview. And if we say... Here, where is that thing?
Add new
analysis.
Yeah, that's going to work.
And now it doesn't show me the red. I'm a
look,
happy camper.
And look how fast. Yeah. Because you saw poop, 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 poop.
I'm a happy camper. So, all right, this is an important one, folks. Use the import from the file menu and then...
First, turn off lyrics.
And then do this. It's going to save us a lot of time. One from my own is... Switch off the Cloud Sync if you have it enabled. I don't know if people can see my subscription plan if I'm going to do this, but let's give it a shot. Library Sync, we go to My Page. It's there. All right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is why we do this, Peter.
I still have to get used to that. And here we... All right. This one is not...
Deactivated by default.
Yeah, it's... all right.
The Cloud Sync, you will only have access if you first activate a plan.
Yeah, and there's a plan activated and on my big account.
Yes.
And I did deactivate it there, and that, I found out, makes importing and analysis a whole lot faster. So if you are going to import your collection from Rekordbox 5, turn off that lyrics, make sure that you import it through the file menu, and then switch off the library sync for that moment, and do what Jeroen just learned us, add analysis, and it will be a lot faster. This is going to be a time saver, that's for sure.
Definitely, yeah.
That's for
and
sure.
Unfortunately, this is something that is not yet made clear. I think it's not made clear enough on the things, and to be honest, a lot of people have read the press release and only saw the word subscription and stopped with the rest. I must also say that if you start Rekordbox, these things that I just explained, it's not mentioned very clearly. And it would be better if Pioneer would have put like checkboxes, what do you want, as a first step as a setup, but unfortunately it's all done by the DJ himself.
Yeah, and that's why we do this kind of streams, folks. All right, we got questions, Jeroen.
Oh, man.
Liam K., a man of my heart. Is the Rekordbox XML export coming back? You can hear the needle dropping, right?
There's like 25 things I want to say, but in this case, I have to revert back to the official answer, and that is that we do not give any information about future development at this point in time. I cannot tell you that. I'm not aware of that, and officially, it's not been announced.
I can always add something more, because users of my products need that export XML functionality often. Right now, there is a possibility to read the new database. I can read it. I can even create an XML out of that database. However, first of all, Pioneer DJ, and that's not Jeroen this time around, but
the big
company in Japan took away that export capability for a reason. I don't know the reason. It's anybody's guess, and I think we can guess pretty well in which direction that goes, but there is no official word for it. I'm good with Pioneer DJ. That's the reason why Jeroen is with me as well. I'm not going to jeopardize that relationship with Pioneer, because Pioneer has been nothing but good to me over the years. So I'm not going to jeopardize that. And for that reason, I'm not going to do the export XML without their blessing. I can make the app. It's very easy. It's not very complicated, but I need their blessing, because if I don't have the blessing, I not only risk my relationship with Pioneer, there is even more, because they can change it on the dime if they want to. They can change it like that. So we can now access, with the current version of Rekordbox 6, the Rekordbox database. However, if Japan thinks, all right, that's bad news, it's all over the net, everybody knows how to do it now, that means that they can pull it and take it away entirely. And then you are left with nothing, and I was left with 5 days of coding to make sure that everything worked. I'm not interested in that. So two reasons why I'm not going that route yet, and I think I never will, because I need the blessing from Pioneer for it. And I by no means am a fanboy of Pioneer or any other company in the industry. I'm a free spirit. I speak my mind. I'm a straight shooter. You all know that. But it doesn't make sense to do this without consent from Pioneer, because they can change it and it's bad for business. Simple as that.
Then you're going to have to run like you have something, you crack it, it's going to get protected again, and then you're going to crack it again. And it's a lot of waste of time. And Peter can say a little bit more about it, as you hear. I'm a employee of Pioneer DJ, and I need to comply with the rules that we have. But it's good that you mention it like this, Peter.
All right. I didn't met Lime brought it up. All right. Time got another question, because Time is telling me that he has a CDJ USB prepared by Rekordbox, and he needs to analyze the tracks again. How can he do that? And I'm not completely clear with what he means, because I think if you have a Rekordbox prepared CDJ USB, you should be good to go. But maybe he means he wants to do that for the colored waveforms.
Okay.
We got a prepared slide for
guys, there will be soon. I'm going to do a presentation and a video as well for Rekordbox 6 on our official channels, and I brought that presentation because I had a feeling that it would be nice to show some slides so you have a more picture of the whole thing. And please also watch my stream. It will be on next Tuesday, 14 o'clock. It will be in Dutch only. The English version will be 1 or 2 days later. But perhaps if I hear this question, it feels a little bit like the, I don't know the name of the guy anymore, but it feels
Tijn.
He doesn't understand the system properly. Can my screen go back to
I give you your screen and I give you one.
be able to analyze the tracks on the USB, it's getting a mess where all this data will be stored. So I would format the USB and export the tracks again from Rekordbox after you have Rekordbox add the missing data.
All right. I'm playing a little bit with my Rekordbox here. Because, like I told you, I've got a Nexus 2 kit here. And like Jeroen just explained to us, we can no longer use the Nexus 2s in HIT mode. I can still do it in my beloved Traktor, and basically they are here as a controller for Traktor, which Jeroen hates, but well, that's how I use them. But I wanted to explain to you guys that there is still a way to use this kind of equipment with your laptop, with your computer, if you have it in the booth and you want to feed tracks from your computer in it.
And you want to browse from your computer or search with the keyboard.
Yep. So what I basically wanted to do, Jeroen, is taking the overhead cam here and just show the folks the ProLink capabilities of the whole.
I think that's a great idea.
Of the whole thing. So people understand, all right, I cannot use them as HIT. I cannot use them as a controller for Rekordbox. But I can still use them to play. So let me get that overhead cam.
The ProDJ Link is a system. I will fill in the time that you move the camera.
I know,
Peter. The ProDJ Link is a way how you can hook up your computer in export mode to a whole DJ booth. You can do that by
connecting your computer to the switch that's in your booth via Ethernet or Nexus 2. You can also use the USB cable.
Just to mention that there's a little bit of echo within the
for systems as we speak. Oh, that's the one. Oh, hold on. It's my fucking phone.
Alright, phone is off. Sorry, my bad. I always fall for that. That's because I'm using iOS for OBS.
Tijn, dankjewel.
Jeroen, say something in your...
In my mic? My mic is on. Tijn, dankjewel. Als het goed is, hoort het nu goed te zijn.
The feedback loop? There should not be a feedback loop at all. Is it fine now, folks? Can somebody tell us in the audio if our audio is up? Because otherwise we have to tweak that first.
In the meantime, I will make sure that there is a little bit of sound going.
You are going to link.
Yes.
And it always takes time for the people to actually react.
Groeneweg, feedback loop. It's good now. Yeah!
Yay, we are good. Yay. We have this. We have this.
Sorry, guys. We're live. And
almost 100 years of DJ experience in the house. And we got bad sound.
Okay, guys. Sorry for the thing. I hope everything is clear for the first half hour. Otherwise, we're just going to do it again.
It was just bad when I moved the thing.
Die HID gooit in de...
Alright, and I've had this often, Jeroen, so I wanted to see you to see this, why that's...
Yes, but now I need to fix some cabling and stuff like that.
The cabling is fine, let me show you how to fix it. I switch off both my players. Then I turn on the first one.
And then I remove the USB lead.
No, you don't need to remove everything. Hold on, buddy. I know my system. I wait till it's fully... started up, fully up, and then I can already link to it, because now it is active, it should be, you see, then I boot that one up.
But that's a strange situation, because that should not happen.
Well, it's happening to me all the time. If I'm booting them up in consecutive order too fast, things go wrong.
That's a weird one. Okay, what's the biggest advantage of the system as you see it here? You can use it either way. You can use your computer and then use the mouse and then drag a file to any of the decks. This is also why you might want to enable load lock in one of your settings. Oh, people don't see it. In the settings of the CDJs, there's an option called load lock. I can also not show it on the display, but it's in the preferences of Rekordbox. You guys are going to find it. It's right here in your My Settings. If you go to Player and if you go to DJ Settings, this is also new, by the way, in Rekordbox 6. You have a nice categorized way of storing all the things. This is an option called Eject Load Lock, and it's set to unlock. What this means is you can, whenever you drag a track, it's always gonna load that track. If you put this one on lock, as if the deck is running, you cannot load a new track, and that might... I turned it off. But if you turn that setting to lock, and if you want to drag a new track... you have to load your settings on the CDJ in order before it to work, because the settings are not applied.
That has been that's all the time, but I'm glad I'm not the product specialist here.
And this is also...
Hold on, let's get cam.
Yeah, because this is something I want to explain also.
Let's get it on cam and let's zoom in a little bit so people get a better view and better understanding of what they're looking at. The iOS cam, I always have to...
You got a lot of scenes over there.
Yeah, you have to, because people want to see stuff. Let's take the left one.
The left one. What do you need to do? You need to first load your settings. So you go to the thing that you want to load. If you're in this screen, like this listing, or you are one step ahead, you press your menu button, and that's where you want to load. What I wanted to show is if a deck is running and you want to load your settings. It's not loading because the first one is grayed out, so you cannot change it. What you have to do is hold the deck, or you're going to press the play button, Then you see you have load, and now it's going to load your settings. Now the load lock should be activated. So if we go back to the computer, and now let's see if I'm going to fall again. But this is what you now see, that the loading is disabled for the specific device. So now you have to hold the platter, so or put it on pause, and now you can load a new track, and now it's going to get loaded. So this is how you're going to load the settings and how you can prevent from accidentally loading a new track if that's not what you intended to do.
All right, Jeroen, is the XDA 1000? Jeroen Groeneweg is asking, I also got a 900 Nexus 2 with the XDA 1000. And ProLink can only be applied in expert mode, not in performance mode. But that's correct.
Yes, that's correct.
Expert mode only feature.
Yes.
All right, so that's perfectly normal, Jeroen. That's the way it's supposed to work.
Yes.
All right, do we have more questions? No, that was that question. Please repeat the ProLink stuff, very interesting. I hope it's clear now, Jeroen. And a little bit, I always try to keep things just out of the red. So we try to be a little bit kind to the levels, folks. So I give them a lot of overhead. I also did it as a DJ. I like overhead on my mixer. I like overhead on my audio. So I'm not going to turn them up. This is how I try them to be without clipping, etc.
We are trying to push out a consistent level so you can make your adjustments at home, no matter how hard you want to have it. But if we are going to do the clipping over here, and Peter and I are both the guys that are using only the green LEDs, because yep. Red means something.
Red is for hookers. Red is always for hookers.
And red is dead. Because there's no life, no dynamics anymore in your sound. The mixer should not be able to go clipping if you're normally using everything. But if you connect your players to the mixer, it's almost impossible to clip on the channel. So that's also something I want to give everybody as advice. If you have CDJs or XDJs that have a digital output and your mixer has a digital input, please use it. It's just better. It saves you 2 times sample noise. But I think that's a little bit too deep for the stream of today to explain sample noise.
All right. But what we are going to do is we are going to sync an iOS device. I've got my El Cheapo throwaway not really active.
My microphone staat niet aan.
Your mic is test, on. Your mic is on, buddy.
Test. It should be there, time. It should be there. Anyway, geloof het wel.
Your mic is on all the way.
Yeah.
So we are going to sync an iOS device with Rekordbox because I was confused by that. That was the first thing I tried because I like to sync my iOS device. And I was having some problems with that. Do you want to use my Rekordbox collection, Jeroen, or do you want to go for yours?
I'm just going to see that my phone is also connected to your Wi-Fi.
Really?
I have no idea why, but
those are the wonders of iCloud and Apple knowing everything.
But this gives me the opportunity to show my Apple TV. Whoa, this is not going to work. Because normally I should have...
You got my Apple TV on. Or so.
I love it on your computer. We'll do it on your computer.
All right.
What I was trying to do is that I have... I have an application on my phone called Air Server, and this would give me a very easy way to show you guys on the screen of my phone on my computer. We didn't test this enough on forehand, so we're going to use the camera, I think.
I've got the overhead camera ready for my iPhone, and I'm going to switch. Let's go to the front screen first, which is this one. All right, start out with that one, and if you need the...
Okay, so let's say you want to have this file, and you want to have that on your phone.
I think you have to make a playlist there, because that works easier.
It can also go by file, but let's make a playlist.
Oh, there are playlists there. What
you can do, and this is a nice way to show off the playlist palette. I'm going to create 3 tracks, and I'm going to drag them up into the blank list. It's going to create a playlist automatically. And you can open that by using this icon on the left. So now I have here my little playlist. Fast. Let's say I want to put this playlist on my phone. The first thing that that's the camera. The first thing that you need to do is on your screen go to create a connection between your phone and your computer. In order for that to work, they need to be connected to the same network, probably by Wi-Fi. So you're going to search for mobile. And what you see is that you need to disconnect the link, because if the link is connected, you cannot do any other transfer. So you have search mobile. And now Rekordbox is waiting for a device to be found. It's looking for it. Now you have to go to...
iOS.
Now you have to go to your phone. And on your phone, you have the new version of the app. This is a separate install in comparison to the previous version. So if you have the old version, you might need to re-download this version of the app. It's a free version, so you can just download it. So you need to make that connection with your phone. Then you go to the settings, and the top settings is connect to Rekordbox. If you press that, your phone is now open for connection with your computer. If you look at the...
Desktop is small, the boven.
Kut plek hier voor die muis. Hoe doe jij eens?
Jeroen is learning how to work with the mouse. He's used to a trackpad.
There's like 15 choices. And now we're back to the phone. Fortunately, I was not doing this, guys.
This is me.
So here you will see that your phone is detected by Rekordbox. And when you connect to it, you connect to it. And this gives a warning because Peter is always trying a lot of stuff from his phone. So he last tried it from a different computer. So this is a notification that actually says, hey, the stuff that's on the phone is being synchronized with a different computer. I'm fine with that. So now there is this connection. And when I go to my playlist, when I right click, I normally would say that... Hey. It dropped the connection.
It did.
Old phone.
There you are.
Let's try it again. Connect. I do it niet beter. I don't think it's gonna work this way.
Really?
Yeah, this is why I always use my own stuff, because it's synchronized with a different thing. Can you move to my screen?
Sure.
Oh, nee, dat werkt ook niet werken. We had to prepare a little bit better because my phone is... We have to get back to this, Peter.
Yes, you think so? This is because it's okay to override it. That's the whole point of it.
Yeah, but you don't get that message. You need to clear it from that side.
How can I clear it from this side? Can I just clear it?
Nee, but...
All right, folks, let's not spend too much time. I owe you.
We'll get back to this again, because my phone also got... I tried, but it's...
Obviously, it pays to rehearse sometimes. And you can still see this is not scripted. We are just doing this on the go and on the fly.
But if we reverse, it would be a lot less fun.
Yeah, because this is like jazz. We just move along with it and see what we can mess around with.
What I wanted to show you, and one of the things is you need to have everything selected in the same network. If it's connected to internet, but it's not connected to the same network, it's not going to work. If you have your phone synchronized with a different library, that's also not going to work, because it's not possible to have one phone that you are exporting stuff to from several different computers, because Pioneer wants to stay away a little bit by the file sharing possibilities of the system. We're always aware that Rekordbox should not be a way how people can share a lot of files, because respect the artist and just buy the music that you do. Well, so if you have your collection set, you just right-click on a playlist, or you right-click on a track, and there's, when you connect your phone, there's an option to move your files to the phone, or you copy files to the phone, and that's available for the free subscription. If you would have the creative, you could also push them to the cloud, but that's not something we want to dive in probably for today. I think that the features of the free plan are the nicest to talk about. Okay, let's do it. Okay, so are we there?
Hold on. Start out with the desktop and then you can go to the iOS.
Overhead first. Okay, let's start it from the get-go. First thing that you need to do is you need to connect your decks, both or all the decks. Only the left is in view, so I'm going to position everything on this left deck. So you need to connect your deck via network to the switch. You need to connect the switch to your computer. That's just out of reach on the right side. So your computer is also connected to the network. So then you have a connection. If you turn on the devices in the proper order, then we're going to move to Rekordbox, and I'm going to show you which button you're going to press on Rekordbox. After about 10 to 15 seconds, that link button Peter just clicked very fastly, it's the button in the left corner. This button, if you press that, the link is being established. Now you see the two decks that are joined in this link. And now you can use it on two ways, because I'm going to tell something we didn't tell the first time, because otherwise it's going to be boring. You have a track, and you can... I see Age of Love, so I want Age of Love. So you can just drag it to the deck. And you see the player status here as well. It's green, so it's automatically going to start. If I'm going to hold the deck, and I'm going to make a cue point, you will see that it's in cue mode, and... Oh, yeah. Oh, sorry. We're learning. I'm just going to... If you press this, you will see on the screen that green box. In the previous shot, you saw the green thing flash, and now you're going to press the button. So this is how you're going to use it in the link. But you can use it also in a different way. Zoom in on the screen. Yep. Because... Digital zoom, pixels, stuff like that.
Exposed everything at the same time.
Okay. So now the deck is just playing like it is... used to. It's just 1 second, Peter. If you hold it, it will be enough. So now, if you drag a file, and you will not see it on the screen, but what will happen if I drag a new file to the deck? You will see it immediately. It starts loading the deck. So that's one way. You can use your mouse and your screen on your computer. That could be the thing that you prefer to do, but I also like to use it the other way around. So if you now press the record as an input source, so not the USB or the SD, not the link that you normally would do, but you're going to press the record button, record box button, now you're browsing all the files that are available on your computer system. You can browse them here in the screen. When you go back, you will see that there's 180 songs, there's 9 playlists, and you can just browse whatever you want and find a track. And oh shit, I'd pick a random track, Peter.
You can pick random tracks all the way.
Yeah, for the Dutch guys, the track was called Hou Je Bek en Bef Me. I have no idea that those tracks are existing. I'm going to take Age of Love because I know that track.
You don't know Merel?
Hey, one of the fun things that I want to share within this system, and we didn't rehearse this, so perhaps I should just check it on the other deck. Okay, I'm just going to load any keep your computer. I'm just going to load any track in the other deck. So I'm going to show you on this deck. So that's what we needed to find out. So there is a track playing on the other side because I want to tell you a little bit more about the Pro DJ Link system and how you can use it and what you can do with it. On deck 2, there is a track running. I don't know what it is, but it's there. I'm going to show the display here, Peter. Yes. So the next deck is running. And what you can do if you are browsing on a deck locally and you're browsing a track list, so you're browsing a track, when you press the button, info, you will see on the right side of the display of the CDJ, you will see all this information of this track. And no matter which track you get the album art and you get a bunch of information. But there's more hidden on this button, because if I hold the info button, what you now see is an overview of the Pro DJ Link. This is connected to the previous story. So what you now have is two buttons. On the left you have a button for player 1 and player 2. These are the two illuminated. So this link is consisted of two. I see an encoding overload message in OBS, but we're just going to run with it. So this is the deck number. So this is deck number 1. And what I actually want to do is there is a track running on deck 2, and I want to have a track that matches it a little bit. So I'm going to press deck 2. So now I get the information of the track that's running in the other deck. And by the way, here you see a computer with a 1. So the source of the music file of deck 2 is computer 1. What you now can do is when you navigate the information you see here, and I would want to say you get tempo, but then in order for that you have to have the BPM also as an active category. But let's say I want to find a track that matches in key with the deck in number 2. I'm just going to use my rotary, go to key, and I'm just going to press it. Now I see the key choices. So the top one is the same key. This is with a little bit of variation, and this is with more variation. So now I'm just going to browse, and I know for certain that all the tracks that are in this list are key perfect match with the track in the other deck. So this is a way how you can use the link to get information back and forth the different decks and find tracks that are matching the tracks that you're playing at this point in time.
You see, I learn something every day.
Yes! Woohoo! That's the fun stuff, because there's actually a lot of stuff hidden, and normally I would use this to walk on BPM, but again, then in Rekordbox you also have to have that set to the active category. Kennedy?
Yes, are you on to go to?
Yeah, to the computer? Because now everybody is going to ask, active category, what do you mean? Well, if you go in Rekordbox to your settings, the first from DJ system, as it's called now, it used to be called CDJ and devices. If you have the second tab, like the category, and we have to disconnect the link because it doesn't like. Nope, you have to close the preferences before you can stop the link. Category, so what you have on the right are the active called categories, and as you see there's the key, but there's not the BPM. That's why I didn't have the BPM. So if you move the BPM to the active category on the right side, this actually is the browse order of the browse menu of your CDJ. Oh, I'm pointing at a CDJ, but you don't see it. Doesn't really matter. And also on sort, I would advise to have BPM and key on sort as well. So now we have set the BPM also as an active category. So the next time when you are on a CDJ and you are looking at the link information, you cannot only get a track that's matched in key, but you can also get a track that's matched in tempo.
Which is all very nice, but as all of my users know that we always sort on command field, not this one, but there's a reason for that, and let me show you that. Because on command field, you basically have, if you have processed them with my tools, the key, the BPM, and energy level in one single thing sorted. So you can go straight ahead through whatever you want.
True. That's why we work for different companies, Peter. I'm always trying to figure out a solution that's within the Pioneer system. Oh, there's nobody in screen. That's my choice. Why do I have a fight with my... that's also running a little bit behind. I just have to stand here. That's about the ProDJ link. No, because you can change the key notification that Rekordbox is using in Rekordbox settings. Yeah, you go in Rekordbox, you go to the settings. I saw you already move to the thing. You go to settings or preferences, and then the first tab is view. And then at the bottom, you will see key display format, and it can be in classic and it can be in alphanumeric. And perhaps if you're using the Camelot wheel, you have a favor for the alphanumeric, and I think you would have that as well. Shoot, yes.
My audio was off. All right. What I basically was saying, if you use in-ears and you don't hear the master in your cues on a DGM system, press the master cue button and then it will work. If you don't press that button...
In order for that to work, you have to have this one on split as well.
Yep.
That's also something, because the top button has a choice to mono split or stereo. Stereo, both ears let you listen to the same sound source. If you split it, it can be split. One side can be the master or it's silent. The other side can be one or multiple channels that you select. This button changes the mix level between the cued and the master of the secondary headset. And of course, you have your volume. By the way, if you guys are DJing at home and you turn on your volume for the headphone over 12 o'clock, turn down your speakers because it's way too loud.
Well, always mind your own ears, folks. It's what makes you earn your money. Yes, Pedro, we already went over the XML thing. It's halfway.
Hey, Pedro.
Extreme.
Pedro.
Yeah,
hey.
Pedro's in the house. Our buddy. We always meet Pedro at basically every show we in Holland we are at. We see Pedro. So hi, Pedro. All right. Let's see. I'm looking if I've got more questions lined up. We are running for more than an hour. Folks, I wait 1 minute if there are more questions. I have a lot of questions still, but let's not make it this too long. I'm sure I can invite Jeroen over a second time or another time.
You cook my favorite food, Peter. I'm here every time.
I'm a great McDonald's chef. So we just invite Jeroen back, let's say next month, to have that iOS thing and maybe some new stuff that came up, new questions that came up. Yeah, Pedro, you messed up the time zones, buddy. We are an hour ahead of you.
But it's a good thing that YouTube stores all the streams so you can just watch it back and see us fighting the technology. I will fill also a few seconds because I liked being here. I had a lot of fun with Peter. I hope we had a lot of information that can help you get a more understanding of the whole situation or that we could address the questions that you came into. I loved being here, and Peter, when you want to have me again, I'm open for it, so would be nice.
Great, great. I see some things, Pioneer Hardware response to Pro. Oh, the response, Lime is asking a question for me, I guess, Jeroen. He's asking me to compare Pioneer to the Prime 4, for instance. Let me tell you this. First of all, it depends on what kind of a DJ you are. If you are like me, just a tech head and you don't mind, you don't have to play clubs, you don't have to play festivals, you don't mind at all where you're playing, then Denon is great because it's great hardware. It costs less than Pioneer stuff, but there is one thing you have to keep in mind. The weakness of the whole Denon ecosystem is Engine Prime. And of course, with Rekordbox 5, not with Rekordbox 6, with Rekordbox 5, to a certain extent, you can use Rekordbox as the collection manager for Denon. It's not very nice, but you can do that. Using My Tools, you can even have a perfect conversion from Rekordbox to Denon. But then still, the weak link is Engine Prime. So what I always recommend anybody who asks me, what should I buy? First of all, what are you going to do as a DJ? Are you going to spin festivals, clubs, etc.? Then you need to be with Pioneer because that is what you're going to get. And trust me, a stage manager at a big festival is not happy if you carry your Prime 4 up the stage unless you're a laid-back Luke and you are paid by the Denon team. Because they don't want to have to deal with that. They've got the Pioneer gear right there. It's all tuned in into the audio system. So they don't want to bother with it, how perfect it may work. So big stuff needs Pioneer. If you're a home DJ, if you do small parties, if you are a bedroom DJ, nothing wrong with that at all. If you are a wedding DJ, then Denon is your choice. But before you dive in, download Engine Prime. It's totally free. And see if you can live with it. Because I know a lot of people who in the first week that Denon Primes came out, returned the stuff just simply because of Engine Prime. Not because of the hardware, but because of Engine Prime. So if you can live with that, you can live with My Tools, then it can be a great system. I love spinning on it. It's great. I'm a tractor DJ and it feels like tractor in a box. But if you are a DJ who thinks that he is going to be big one day, then Pioneer is your choice. There's no way around it. It's just the way the world works. And this, of course, can never be said by Jeroen, so I say it for him.
I would say this is the question you should answer because obviously I have a certain background and I must agree with Peter, but I wanted to give the Engine Prime a fair chance at the beginning as well with a new Prime system. As a product specialist, I want to investigate what the market is about and how stuff works. I don't like the marketing talk, so I want to have hands-on experience. And let's say that my first evening with Engine set the benchmark, and I will leave you up to decide how that went. Peter can apply about that a little bit better than me, because I'm a little bit prejudged, but it was a lot tougher than I would have expected it. I really would have thought it was a more gentle experience.
The Primes as a hardware platform are great, but you are not a DJ on an island, you are a DJ in a big world where you need to perform in front of an audience. And that's the point where you have to see that, all right, it's not a standard, and you can like it or not. VHS was a master over Betamax and even Video 2000, who both were...
VCC.
who both were much, much, much better quality video systems, but it's just the law of the big numbers, and the big numbers win the show. Let's see, do I have something else? All right, Tijn is asking if he can use the iOS version on Rekordbox 5.8.5, and I don't think he can, but maybe you can.
No, because the old 5.8.5 does not have the button to search for a mobile device, so you cannot use the new app with the old one. What you can do with the old app and Rekordbox 5.8, if you hook in your lighting cable or your cable to your phone, you can use your phone as a device to export tracks to. So you can export a playlist or your tracks to your phone.
And you can connect them to the CDJ.
Yes, I would not use this as your main source of your tracks, because you will always see that once you're in the middle of a stream, people start calling and you forget to turn it on silent or turn it off. But if you bring your phone with you and you have your lighting cable and you just put it in the USB in port on the top left of the CDJ deck, you can use your phone as a device with tracks. But I would suggest using a USB, because it is possible, but see it as a backup.
Yeah, Tijn, that is for the old app. And let me add to that for the new app, and this also is for the old app. What you have to realize yourself is that Apple knows something that is called a sandbox, which means a certain app cannot look to data outside of its own little sandbox. And in case of Rekordbox, the iOS app, it means it cannot see your iTunes tracks, which means if you have a track you really like and you already had on your iPhone, because you are like me, you're using Algorithms DJ, which uses iTunes tracks, but you want to have the track in Rekordbox iOS as well, that track will be a duplicate on your iPhone. One inside the iTunes ecosystem and one inside the Rekordbox ecosystem. So it will take up twice the storage space, and we all know how pressure our storage space on an iOS device is. So keep that in mind. If you use the Rekordbox iOS app, and it's a great app, the last app is really great. I didn't like the old one, but I really like the new one. But it's in a sandbox, so all your tracks are in a sandbox. No way you can access them outside that sandbox. So they will be duplicates on your iPhone. Keep that in mind. I see some more questions coming in, buddy.
Do we still have them? Yeah, I just do a double check on the iTunes thing with the old app. And indeed, it's not available. So you were totally right, but I always like to double check.
The DJM Rec app is very unstable on iOS 13, says Jeroen Groeneweg. I cannot comment on that. I don't use it, so maybe you can.
I have no issues with the app, but that's unfortunately something that happens more often. There is a need for the latest if you are using the iOS version 13, you have to make sure that the firmware of a Nexus 2 is at least 2.6 or 2.06 or 2.07. So mandatory to also bring the firmware for the mixer. And to be honest, if you're reaching in a club, the club is in full swing, it will happen again. You don't want to update the firmware of the mixer, because at the end of the firmware update, you need to reboot the mixer. And this is not something you should do when a mixer is live. You should always prepare that ahead. So firmware version is required. Latest firmware version is required for iOS 13 and up.
And folks, that by the way is for every firmware update. Never update your firmware, never update your apps a day in front before you have your gig. If you are at your bedroom, if you're preparing your tracks and there is an update of my apps, don't take it. Stay in the realm you know. Same with Rekordbox. Update for Rekordbox, don't take it.
If you have a big show tomorrow.
Update after the gig, the Sunday after the gig, after you slept through and you are still all happy that it went so well, then it's time to update. Not in front of a big gig. Trust me, I've fallen for this mistake more than once in my life that I just thought, what the heck, I'm going to update whatever device just before a show. I'm going to update my iOS, which is my backup with the Algorithms DJ, just before a show. Don't do that. Never.
Only update if you know the outcome. And I agree totally what Peter says. If you're not sure and you just think, oh, hey, there's a new update, let me follow the new update, please do it when you have the time for it. I come across a lot of situations where I even update firmware live because people need features that are supported by the latest version, either for the CDJ or whatever. So I'm not scared, but in general, I know what's going to happen and what I can suspect. So then I take an educated guess in performing the update. But I think Peter's advice is the best. If you have something big coming up, don't update. It's got the same with Adobe. I needed to get a video rendered. I'm going to update, and then the whole media manager was changed. Then you have to figure that out, and then you're going to miss your deadline. So even if it's like DJ gear or if it's other software, best to do the update when you have time to spend on it. And if something goes wrong, it always goes wrong at the moment that you cannot have it. So do it when you have a free Sunday ahead.
Murphy's Law is always there, folks. All right. Thank you, Jeroen, so much for joining our little stream and having you here. I hope you guys learned a lot today, or at least a little maybe.
Or had fun, because that's the most important.
Because that's basically why we do this kind of stuff, to learn, to educate, and to have fun. So stay with me for next time. I think Jeroen also wants to promote his DJ Resource channel, of course.
Yeah. DJ Resource on YouTube. I've been doing a few streams in the last 2 weeks. I will be doing probably streams on a Tuesday the next coming weeks. Next Tuesday it's going to be about Rekordbox 6. I know you will see the slides that I showed you today again, but then you hear the full story. And just check me out on YouTube, DJ Resource.
And as always, check out my tutorials. You know the drill. I see Jeroen Groeneweg with a lost question, if an external drive is a problem for Rekordbox 6. No, it's not. It doesn't matter where your tracks are stored, as long as you make sure that drive is mounted the moment you fire up Rekordbox 6.
And if you have a Windows machine, please map the drive letter of the external drive, because if you sometimes when you hook it up to a different USB port, it's going to get a different letter, and then all your tracks are missing. So map the drive if you're using an external drive on Windows.
All right, thank you all for watching. We will be back, I think, next time. I will be back next time, and I hope Jeroen will be here quick.
I'll probably be here somewhere in the future, and let's take it away.
All right, Mixmaster G is signing off.